In screwed news, should DuPont be facing the corporate death penalty? That company is currently facing thousands of lawsuits from residents from West Virginia to Ohio and in all those communities in between where DuPont contaminated drinking water in the area with a cancer-causing toxic chemical. To make matters worse, it appears that the contamination was going on for more than 5 decades. And the icing on the cake? Well, DuPont knew that the water was contaminated with a chemical known as C8, but they did nothing about it. Joining me now for more on this is Ned McWilliams. He's the one fighting this battle, consumer advocate, great lawyer. Ned, welcome. Thanks for joining me. Exactly what is C8? Lay this case out. This is an ugly little case. Tell us how ugly it is.
It is indeed. It's a storyline right out of Aaron Brockovich. It's truly a despicable story of a criminal conduct on the part of DuPont. It's a community of about 80,000 people, and DuPont was using a chemical called C8, which lots of people know it's used in Teflon. And it was contaminated the drinking water supply for more than 50 years. The company knew it was leaking into the groundwater, into the drinking water. They were going out and secretly testing people's drinking water, testing hospitals and schools.
Let me ask you something. You threw a lot in there. You mentioned Teflon. C8 is used to make Teflon, and the scientist that looked at this case said that C8 causes testicular cancer. It causes prostate cancer, anything, any other cancers in addition to that?
Yeah, kidney cancer, testicular cancer, and a really terrible disease, ulcerative colitis, which is a form of inflammatory bowel disease.
Okay, so DuPont knew about this. I mean, the notes I have is DuPont knew about it in the early 50s when their own scientists said, hey, you know what? We've got something that's dangerous here. It was so dangerous that 3M actually ended up taking off the market. How do they justify this?
Well, they can't justify it. There's no way they can even just try to justify it. All they're doing now is they're phasing it out. They say they're going to quit using it, and they're sorry. But unfortunately, sorry doesn't help the 80,000 people they've contaminated over the last 50 years.
Isn't this criminal conduct? I mean, isn't this the same as saying to your neighbor, oh, by the way, I didn't want to tell you, but 5 years ago, I started putting arsenic in your swimming pool, and I just forgot to tell you. That would be criminal assault. That's what that is.
Yeah, only thing we worse is if you're drinking your swimming pool water.
Okay. I mean,
yeah, they were secretly putting chemicals in people's body without their permission.
Okay,
and you're right. That's criminal.
So there's a criminal part of this where they've obvious criminal conduct. It is criminal assault. They've committed perjury. Would you agree with that? If I look at the story here, they committed perjury in their reporting to government agencies. Is that accurate?
Yeah, for failing to provide documents, for destroying documents, not giving them to the courts, not giving documents to the EPA. Absolutely.
And they obviously there's fraud involved. They committed a fraud on the entire public, which obviously is a criminal fraud. But nobody has gone to jail, have they?
Not yet, but I think the Department of Justice is going to be really interested to see the work we've put together just in the last few months.
Well, Ned, let me ask you something. People misunderstand what criminal conduct requires. And you've got the intent aspect. That is, did they intend to do this? Sometimes conduct is so bad that the conduct rises to recklessness, and that recklessness replaces intent. Is that how the law works?
Yes, sir. That's how the law works. But here we have reckless, but I think we have intent. I think the only debate is about whether or not they thought they were going to do harm. But they intentionally discharged these pollutants, these contaminants, into people's drinking water. And they knew or should have known that it was going to cause the harm that it did.
Especially
considering what they were saying internally. They were telling their own employees, don't be exposed to this stuff. You want to avoid exposure. They're telling their own employees internally, this stuff is a carcinogen. They're telling their own employees, you need to wear a respirator when you're around this stuff. Yet they were allowing 80,000 men, women, and children to drink this stuff for 50 years. That's criminal.
Ned, one little part of this, we're short on time here, but one part of this is that women had pregnancy complications when they worked around this product C8 that, as you point out, is a component of Teflon, a Teflon pan that you might use in your kitchen to fry eggs. One component is C8, and it was causing pregnancy complications, birth defects, right?
Yes, sir. Birth defects. They did a little study. Anecdotal reports of women having giving birth to babies with birth defects. So they commissioned a study. There was 10 babies born to employees that were exposed to C8. 20%. 20% of the babies born to women that are exposed to C8 in the workplace gave birth to babies with birth defects.
15 seconds, Ned, what do you say to DuPont tonight?
I think it's time they come to the table and they tell the community they apologize and they clean this up.
Thank you, Ned. Appreciate it. Stay on them.